The commitment was made to Parliament by the Minister of State for Youth and Children Affairs, Sarah Mateke, following a report by the Parliamentary Committee of Gender, Labour and Social Development, which implicated Prime Linkages Limited for neglecting a one, Anit Nakagulide, externalised by the company to Saudi Arabia and neglected there. Mateke noted that the Ministry of Finance has finally provided funds to recruit labour attachés,
which we were ready to work on as a ministry, and we thank God that the girl came and for the recommendations that they have made, Right Honourable Speaker, we are willing to work on them and we are not seated.
The Gender Committee report indicates that the health of the victim deteriorated following her return from Saudi Arabia, but no support was extended to the victim.
To the ambassador, the victim received medical attention while at the shelter pending the process of exit visa. On 17th August 2022, the victim was repatriated after her exit visa was provided. The committee has since interacted with her relatives, according to whom she was experiencing a deterioration in medical health, and has been receiving treatment from the National Psychiatric Hospital in Botabika.
The labor export company was faulted for neglecting the victim while in the Middle East. It also found out that the Prime Linkages had other outstanding cases of workers who were recruited and died abroad, but instead the company resorted to intimidating relatives.
Linkages was negligent and did not provide the necessary assistance to Ms. Nachigulwe, Nakagulile, and the family, and until the petition was presented to the Parliament.
Members of Parliament are concerned with the plight of migrant workers, questioning government commitment to address those issues. He urged the government to address the push factors which put Ugandan girls in a vulnerable position to leave the country for slavery.
Instead of quarreling with the recruitment agencies, let's put a fund for quick evacuation, and let's put some small offices in all these big cities where they go and work, and then deal with the problems as they emerge.
The Leader of Opposition, Joel Senyonyi, had urged members of Parliament to follow the graphic stories that are being told by the external labour workers being exposed on X, formerly Twitter, and their families in order to understand the ordeal the workers are going through.
We've not had bilateral agreements with most of these countries. We recently renewed the one we did have with Saudi Arabia. The one with UAE was signed, an MOU, but it's not been legalized yet. And we don't have others. That's a problem, Madam Minister, that needs to be fixed.
The Minister also informed Parliament of the new application through which migrant workers can report cases of inhuman treatment.
And secondly, they have also given us money where we have created an app, which app will be given to each girl that is going outside. In case you get a problem, even if you cannot talk, we shall know that you are located in this area and there is trouble. And then the labor attachés can move very fast to this home to save the life of our girls.
Story compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.